For today's video lecture, we're going to talk about for loops and how many times they iterate. For your homework last night, we reviewed loop basics. So we talked about why do we use a for loop, what the different parts of a for loop are, and how many times it iterates. And I gave you a few examples. So for today's assignment, you're going to work with a partner and you're going to get an assignment that looks similar to this. And you're going to have some questions. How many times does the for loop iterate? So let's just do a few of them for practice. So let's take a look at number one right here on this example. We're going to have x in range 1 to 5. X is my counter, my control loop. It's going to start at 1, and it's going to go up until 5, but it's not going to include 5. So what are the different values of x? It's going to be 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then it's going to stop. So how many times does this loop iterate? It's going to iterate 4 times. Now, if we want to check it, we can get into Code Sculptor. I just put together a very simple little function here. I'm going to use counter to tell me how many times it iterates. And then x is going to be my control variable. That's going to change with the for loop. And then I'm just going to print at the end count. So if I change this, I want to test number 1. I'm just going to put 1, comma 5. And let's just see. So you can see that the x is 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it went 4 times. Let's take a look at the next one. X in range is 7. Now it only gives me one argument for range, and that means the default is 0. So x is going to start at 0, and then it's going to be, so it's going to start at 0. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it going to get to 7? Nope, it's going to just go from 0 to 6. So how many times is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times. So that would be my answer, is 7. Answer up here, 4. So I can come over to my little test program here and I can test it out. Just change this to 7. And there are my answers, 0 to 6, and it did 7 times. Let's take a look at this one. I've got 10. I'm going to start at 10. I'm going to go to 3. And I'm going to go down by 1 because my step is negative. So I'm going to start at 10. Then I'm going to go down to 9. And then 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. And then I'm not going to go to 3. I'm going to stop right there. How many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 times. I can come over here. Let's just do a little test. 10, 3, negative 1. Okay, so 10 to 4, 7 times. And now what about this one? I've got starting at 10, going to 0. I don't have a step, so it's going to go up. We have a little bit of a problem here because my starting value is larger than my ending value. So what do you think? Is it going to start at 10 and it's going to do an iteration? Let's find out. I've got 10 already. Let's put 0 there. Nothing happens. 0 iterations because my starting value was bigger than my ending value. So I'm not even going to have this. It's not going to start the loop at all. So it's going to check the condition first. And the condition is going to start false, so it doesn't even execute the for loop. That's a handy thing to know. Let's start with this one. I've got negative 10. I'm going to go up to 11, and I'm going to go by 3s. So I've got negative 10. And then I'm going to go negative 9, negative 8. So then I have negative 7. Oops. And then negative 6, negative 5. Then I go to negative 4. Then negative 3, negative 2. Then I go to negative 1. Then I have 0, 1. Then I go to 2. 3, 4, I get 5, 6, 7, I get 8, 9, 10, and the next one is 11. Do I get to 11? Right now I'm going to guess no. I'm going to come over here, let's just test it. I've got negative 10, 11, and I'm going to go by 3s. So negative 10 to 8, 7 times. Alright, good job. Now we have one more. We're going to start at 10, we're going to go 5, and we're going to go down by 2. So would this execute? I think so. We're going to start at 10, and we're going to skip every other one. So then I'm going to go to 8, and then I'm going to go to 6, and then am I going to hit to 5? I think we're going to stop right there. So I think 3 iterations. Let's find out. 10, 5, negative 2. So the answer would be... So here's 6 examples for you. You're going to work with a partner and you're going to do 10 examples, all fairly similar to this. And back to the video lecture if you're not sure, or refer to your notes from yesterday. When you're finished, do not turn this paper in just yet. You can keep it in your box. We're going to do the next section, the hand tracing, tomorrow as another group activity.